So like whatever you guys are, yeah, I just want to tell you guys a small story based on the Bible about forgiveness. You know, a lot of people, do bad stuff to us, and sometimes, you know, we need to forgive them. Yeah, we need to forgive them and forget about whatever they have done to us, because at the end of the day, it's written in the Bible, it's very clear that, you know, we need to forgive each other. And if you to see it here in the Bible, it is written in Matthew 19, verse 1, and then there's also 18, starting from 21. You know, from 18, Matthew 18, it says 18:21 says, then Peter came to Jesus and asked, "Lord, how many times shall I forgive my brother or sister who sins against me? Up to 7 times? Jesus replied, "I tell you, not 7 times, but 70 times, 7 times. Therefore, the kingdom of heaven is like a king who wanted to settle accounts with his servant. As he began the settlement, a man who owed him 10,000 bags of gold was brought to him. Since he was not able to pay, the master ordered that he and his wife and his children and all that he had be sold to repay the debt. At this, the servant fell on his knees before him. 'Be patient with me,' he begged, 'and I will pay back everything.'" You know, the story goes on and on, but the truth is, the servant forgave him. The servant, the boss forgave the servant, and you know, he was like, okay, you know, he took pity on him and just let him go. But this same servant actually went on and found another person. And of course, he owned like 10,000 gold from their boss. But for him, he went ahead and met another servant. As he was forgiven, he went ahead and met another servant. And then, you know, it was only 100 silver coins that the other person owed him. And so he grabbed him by the throat, he shocked him, and, you know, he wanted the money to be paid. But then he was like, "Have mercy on me, I don't have the money, give me some time, I will pay your money." But he put him in prison. And then when other servants saw what had happened, they were outraged, and they came back to the servant, and then they were like, "This is what happened." Then he felt so bad, and he also took him and handed him over to the jailers to be punished, because he could have reciprocated what his boss had done to him, to another person. So what am I saying? The Bible is very clear that we need to forgive each other. People can do stuff, but of course, let's not make it in our DNA that every time we are the ones who are going to be at fault, we are doing the wrong things, you know? But make it a point that you are going to be able to forgive one another and do the right thing. Don't make it a habit that every time you're the one who is at fault, you're doing the wrong things, guys. You know, try your level best to do things in the orderly manner. And if anybody does something bad, let's forgive each other and we move forward. By the way, when we forgive one another, we feel a relief on our inside. When we forgive one another, you feel there is that peace that comes with it. You have that compassion against the person who faulted you. You'll be free from diseases such as, you know, the congestion of the chest. There are diseases like allergies and stuff like that if you're more forgiving. There are some people who are naturally more forgiving, but there are other people who are not. But we can always learn to be forgiving to one another so that we live in a better world.